According to the simulation hypothesis, all of reality and the universe is an artificial computer simulation. The simulation hypothesis is a legitimate theory often discussed by physicists, cosmologists, philosophers, and the rest of the scientific community. Even billionaire entrepreneur Elon Musk said recently that we are probably living in a simulation, which essentially means that the Matrix is real and our existence is one big computer game. So are we living in a simulation? That's the question we are asking right now on Life's Biggest Questions. Hello and welcome back to Life's Biggest Questions, the channel that asks the fundamental questions of life. I'm your host, Charlotte Dobre, and if you would like to connect with me and the creative team behind Life's Biggest Questions, the links to our social media accounts are posted in the description. Before I begin this video, do us a solid and hit the thumbs up, subscribe, and notification bell. Picture this. You are a sim. You're a computer-generated character being controlled by an all-powerful being. Your thoughts, your feelings, your entire existence is essentially a lie, created for someone else's entertainment. And the worst part? You have no clue. Pretty scary to think about, isn't it? There are many works of science fiction that present the idea that we are living in a simulation, like The Matrix, Neuromancer, and Ready Player One. But the idea is not new. It actually dates back hundreds, if not thousands of years. The Chinese philosopher Master Zhuang, who lived in the 4th century BC, wrote a story called The Butterfly Dream, where he interprets the universe as a thing that changes spontaneously, controlled by a conscious god. This is the core concept in Taoism. The ancient Indian religion Maya dictates that the universe is a magic show, an illusion where things appear to be present but are not what they seem. Even the Greeks theorized that dreams within dreams could be possible. On the Joe Rogan Experience podcast, Elon Musk said that we are probably living in a simulation. He said that the universe is 13.8 billion years old. That's plenty of time for a complex civilization to develop the systems needed to create a simulated universe, or many simulated universes. The idea that we are living in a simulation essentially supports the theory of the multiverse. Each simulation, or universe, is profoundly more interesting than the original substrate on which they are running. Essentially, there could be an advanced alien civilization that has the capability of creating hundreds, thousands, or even millions of fake universes where the inhabitants have no idea. Neil deGrasse Tyson believes that the odds are 50-50 that our entire existence is a program on someone else's hard drive. The more we learn about the universe, the more it becomes apparent that it is based on mathematical laws. The simulation hypothesis would actually be a viable explanation for the fact that we can't seem to find any other intelligent life forms in our universe, even though the laws of probability dictate that the universe is so vast, there must be someone else out there. According to Rich Terrill, astronomer and director for the Center of Evolutionary Computation and Automated Designs at NASA, you can simulate the universe with a series of equations you can carry around in your pocket, like a video game. Every element of our universe is computable. Every element can be understood individually, but also as a wider mathematical framework that predicts the way the natural world behaves. Terrill says that if we are currently able to do this, then in the future, it could be entirely possible that we could digitally live within simulations. Would it be really such a bad thing if our universe were a simulation? If we were simulated, this could essentially mean that our souls could be reprogrammed into new bodies. It opens up the possibility of eternal life. It would also support the idea of religion. The complex entity controlling us is essentially God, someone looking out for us. So to answer the question, are we living in a simulation? Well, even though the idea is very compelling, according to a team of theoretical physicists at Oxford University, the answer is no. It's physically impossible. Essentially, they calculated that to store the amount of information required to create a universe would be impossible. Storing information about a couple hundred electrons would require a computer memory that would require more atoms than exist in the universe, let alone store all the electrons that currently exist in our universe. The study was published in the journal Scientific Advances. So rest easy, dear subscribers of Life's Biggest Questions. You, your experiences, and your feelings are very much real. Probably. Then again, if we are living in a simulation, there is no way we would know. There are many futurologists that predict that in the future, there could be an enormous amount of computing power possible that we currently could not comprehend, and is being controlled by an entity that's so advanced that it's undetectable to us. This would essentially be impossible to prove, and to this day, no one has. What do you think? Are we living in a simulation? Why or why not? Write your responses in the comments down below. For now, I'm Charlotte Dobre, and you've been watching Life's Biggest Questions. If you want to continue watching this channel, we've set up a playlist that's clickable on the screen right now. And don't forget to hit that notification bell, and we will see you in a future episode of Life's Biggest Questions.